Hello, Moodlings. My name is Dr. Nicole Lunan, and I'm the CEO and co-founder of a new app called MoodMe, an app that allows you to share over 400 plus moods, emotions, and desires with your significant other, thus making a tough thing like communication cute, effective, and super easy. Do you know the difference between a karmic relationship, twin flames, or soulmates? This is something I personally struggled with to understand, because many use the word soulmate so easily and early on in relationships, but how do you really know if you can't tell the difference between the others? In this video, we are going to define what a karmic relationship is, a twin flame, and a soulmate, and talk about the differences between the three, thus leaving you with a better understanding of what you might be working with. In the past, I haven't been a huge fan of this terminology because when people believe they have found a soulmate or twin flame, they tend to use that as an anchor to stay together, even if the relationship is harmful. But that is why I think this video is going to be helpful to bring awareness to the popular terms. I don't believe that there is only one soulmate for one person, but many. And if we can awaken and acknowledge them, then we can find them. Also, watch out for those who try to use these titles at the beginning before they get to know you, because it can often be used as a love bombing technique to pull people in. Every relationship is uniquely different, and the descriptions here may not match exactly what you're experiencing in your union. However, you may use these descriptions as guidelines, not hard set rules. Relationships require constant work and intentional effort. And over time, couples are able to connect on that soul level and feel deeply seen and known by that partner, no matter what the label is. Also, if you like our videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Let's talk about soulmates. Soulmates flow naturally like water. I think you can agree that one of our main goals of life is to find a true, deep, meaningful love. Well, that definitely can be found in a soulmate. A soulmate is any living being that you have an instant and deep connection with. For example, you may meet somebody standing in line at a party and feel just completely drawn to this person's energy. It feels like a home for both of you. That's because the connection between your souls already existed and is something that you just happen to stumble upon. There is an assumption that we can only have one soulmate, and that is incorrect. We can have many soulmates in our lives, and it doesn't have to be in a romantic relationship. They can also be found in a relationship with a pet, friend, or even family member. The mission of a soulmate is to make our journey on the earthly realm pleasant and easy. You may feel like you have known this person in a past life, as they can feel very familiar upon meeting. Our souls are inhabiting a physical body, but just because our outer shell looks different doesn't mean that our souls can't remember each other. So we may get confused because we get caught up on the physical looks when spotting a soulmate, but it's good to look past that and to the root of the soul itself. Many who believe in soulmates also believe in the concept called reincarnation, meaning that our souls have returned to live many different lives, and in one of these lives, you have experienced and bonded with this particular soul before. For those who believe in this, there's comfort there, because if you have somebody who may have passed away or who you lost, who you believe to be a soulmate, there's hope that you will experience and know this soul once again in a different life. So soulmates are highly compatible, very low drama, instant and easy deep connection, not limited to romantic partners, and flows like water and feels like home and a breath of fresh air. A relationship that reminds me of a soulmate relationship could be Lily and Marshall off of How I Met Your Mother.
Maybe we just shouldn't get married at all.
Maybe not.
Pause.
You just like starving.
Totally. Red Lobster?
I want to know you. I know your soul.
It's like they don't see eye to eye on anything.
Totally.
So Lily and Marshall have that deep connection. They work and function as a team, and there's a lot of stability there and a lot of deep, great love. So let's talk about karmic relationships, better known as the wrecking ball. Karmic relationships, sometimes called wrecking ball soulmates, are catalysts for change in our lives. They come in like a wrecking ball to break down self-limiting patterns and beliefs and are change agents. They present opportunities to improve our karma so we can grow and evolve. Karmic relationships are filled with this all-consuming passion, but like anything that intense, it's really hard to maintain. Karmic relationships are not meant to last. However, they provide us good teachers to direct us to where our spirit needs healing. Karmic relationships can feel like a soulmate or a twin flame relationship at the beginning, and you won't know that you're in a karmic relationship until you are in the thick of it. Woo! So karmic relationships are very intense. They have an instant connection, but they're full of drama. There's lack of stability there. You're gonna be stuck in arguments like a broken record. So in a karmic relationship, you might not see the growth until after the relationship is over, so that you can look back on the relationship and figure out how you got into it in the first place and what you can do better in the next relationship. One or both partners refuses to change their behavior, and also they don't want to end the relationship, therefore trapping them in this sometimes toxic makeup or breakup cycle. You might feel like you are destined to be with this person and not understand why it's not working. It's because this person was not meant to be in your life forever, just merely until you have learned about yourself and closed your karmic loop. If you try to hold on to a karmic relationship past its time, you may feel like the worst parts of yourself are being pulled forward and broadcasted. It will also begin to drain your energy, as the universe will provide you obstacles and situations where you have to accept that there's no choice but to end the relationship. Twin flames, get ready for the fire. The twin flame relationship is anything but easy. There's a lot of passion, intensity, and volatility until you can find a way to heal past both of your triggers and insecurities. The love experienced between twin flames is like a wild animal. It cannot be contained and it cannot be captured. It's forever growing and moving and challenging both people to become a better version of themselves so that they can reach spiritual evolution and become one. The concept of twin flames comes from the Greek philosopher Plato, who had the idea that the soul was split into two and that we eternally yearn to find our other halves. Please remember that everybody's journey and what they signed up for is different. Not everybody needs to find their other half to feel complete. If that be the case, it's possible that you may have found your other half in a different lifetime, and in this lifetime, you were meant for a different destiny. All of that is okay. The degree to which you handle a twin flame relationship depends highly on your emotional and soulful maturity levels. To succeed in a twin flame relationship, both of you will have to learn to transcend your ego and put it aside. You will try to run away over and over again just to return back and realize that the bond isn't going anywhere. There's typically a runner and a chaser. The chaser is usually more spiritually evolved than the runner, but eventually they balance out and they settle their differences. Your twin will have a way of shining a light on your insecurities, which can be downright frustrating and painful. There's going to be a purging stage where a lot of arguing will occur, but this is necessary for both of you to work through ego triggers and shed the parts of you that are not helping you to evolve. However, as both of your egos relax, there's a stage of great peace and union. This is called the soul reunion. This may be accompanied with a huge and positive change in your life as both of you come together for one purpose and one mission. It's in the soul reunion that you will become unstoppable, and you will look back on all the pain and adversity that you went through and think that it is all necessary and completely worth it. The more you work through your obstacles with empathy, patience, the easier this relationship is going to be for you. Unfortunately, it is possible to not reunite with your twin flame and reach the soul reunion phase. This all depends on your ability to lead with your higher self and emotional maturity, and less with your ego. It's also possible that these relationships can become very toxic as both or one partner refuses to evolve, therefore trapping you both in an endless cycle of fighting and pain. Because the bond is so soulful and addicting, it's going to be extremely hard to leave. If that be the case, it's okay to accept that maybe in this lifetime you may not reunite, but that doesn't mean in different lifetimes this is going to be the case. Many believe that the work we do in this lifetime will be saved for the next.
Twin flames are highly intense. The relationship is like a wild animal. There's going to be a chaser and a runner. It includes a lot of spiritual growth and evolution. There is motivation to grow and change and become a better person. It's very passionate, and there's a huge shedding of the ego. Some examples of this relationship could be, I don't know if you watch Gossip Girl, but Blair and Chuck.
What we have is a great love. It's complicated, intense, all-consuming. No matter what we do and how much we fight, it'll always pull us in.
So there you have it. The differences between karmic relationships, twin flames, and soulmates. Have you experienced any of these relationships, and can you now tell the difference? We would love to hear from you and what you have to say, so please leave a comment in the section below. Like, share, and subscribe, and